During spring and summer, a favorite pastime for high school students is going to the lake. Little Elm Park, renovated in 2014, is a section of Lake Louisville that consists of a man-made beach. At the park, there are opportunities to play volleyball, swim in the lake, walk the beach, and zip line. Lake Louisville is a common hotspot for our Frisco raccoons to hang out.
Playing beach volleyball is always a great time, and meeting new people, always fun.
Well, I don't like to go swim at the beach or play volleyball, but I do love the zip line on the playground.
We saw this massive plume of smoke in the distance, and so naturally, me and Winston were like, "What's that?" And we went up to this plume of smoke. It turned out to be a bonfire. And it turns out they were all Wakeland athletes having a bonfire at midnight at Lake Louisville.
It's real sandy, but you know, shout out zip lines, lots of random people, you know. That's basically it, you know what I'm saying?
My experience has been really great. I have amazing teams. Shout out Brianna Marie Bellhumer, Nathaniel Thomas Bloomer, Madison Paige Gutman, Lizzie, and also Maria Lawson for going with me at 5 in the morning to WADA and Lake Louisville. It's been great, 10 out of 10.
You know, going around to the beach, go swimming around a little bit, see some people get a nice little tan going on, a little bit of sunburnt.
Oh, you know, I'm out at Lake Louisville every weekend, got the dream team going. Shout out Zachary Hamill, shout out Caleb Monty. Oh, you know, I love Lake Louisville, 10-0 every time I go there. It's a great place to go. Catch me out there on Friday.
Our Frisco raccoons love to spend their free time at the Little Elm Park. It is always a great time to play volleyball, swim, and spend the day with friends. Next time someone tells you to jump in a lake, make sure it's Lake Louisville. For RACC-TV,
she's Maria Lawson.
As the end of our school year quickly approaches, the class of 2017 is faced with some important decisions. According to recent statistics, approximately 70% of high school graduates enroll in college. Many go to work and some haven't decided yet. What are your plans?
What are your plans after high school?
I plan to attend Texas A&M University. Giggum.
I'm going to UT and I'm majoring in business.
I'll be going to Abilene Christian University to study music as a vocal performance major.
I'm going to go straight into work because I don't want to go to college. College is not for everyone.
I think I'll be going to Collin College. Probably going to join some intramural football. Scored one touchdown this year, you know. So picky.
Go Cougs! Roar! Yes.
Or after high school is go to a trade school for welding and mechanics.
Go to the University of Oklahoma. Boomer.
I'm enlisted in the Army, so that's where I'll be going in July.
I'm going to college at Texas A&M to study engineering.
I'm going to go play junior hockey. I don't know where yet, but not going to college.
I'm going to Texas A&M.
I want to do voiceovers for pretty much anything because I have spot-on impressions of stuff.
I plan to attend CSU in chemistry.
I'm going to go to SMU to study business.
Well, I'm planning to do a lot of community service and helping out the community as much as I can, and then going to college and trying to make a better impact on the world.
To live with my parents forever.
What are your plans for after high school?
I don't plan on leaving high school.
As the cost of college rises, students are taking different paths. For example, tuition costs an average of $450 per semester in 1980 to attend UT Austin. Today, that figure has risen to an average of $10,000 per semester. Even with scholarships and other options, college has become a major investment. This has caused some families to consider alternative plans. Besides, a traditional college education is not for everyone. For RACC-TV, I'm Hagen Gardner.
Monty, is ball life?
Yes.
Show me your step back.
Is ball live?
Yeah, bro.
Yes, sir, it is. Catch me at the rec Saturdays through Sundays.
What times?
2 p.m. to 2 a.m.
Okay, sir, may I see your step back, please? Travel.
Show me your step back.
What is
that? Hey, is ball life?
Is ball life?
Let me see your step back. Show me your step back. Hey, is ball life?
Yeah.
Show me your step back. Hey, is ball life?
Yeah.
Show me your step back. Hey, is ball life?
Hey, ball's life, man.
Let me see your step back. Is ball life?
What?
Is ball life?
Ball life?
Ball life.
Never heard of it.
Show me your step back. Show me your step back.
My what?
Show your step back.
Everybody love me when they see me, they be like, there he go.
Is ball life?
Yes.
Let me see your step back.
Jesus. Ball's life all the time, all day.
Show me your step back, man.
Huh? Oh. Show us your step back.
My step back?
Yes.
Hey, yo. Hey, can you get that one more time?
One more time.
Oh, side step. Can I see your step back, ma'am?
What's a step back?
Just, you know.
Is ball life?
Yes,
ball
sir.
Is the life.
Can you show me your step back?
Like this? Right.
Is ball life?
Ball is not life.
Puck
is life. Hey.
Do you consider ball as life?
Yes.
Show me your step back.
My step back? No, thank you. I'm good.
One of the most popular and unique activities that continues to grow is skateboarding. By most accounts, skateboarding originated by California surfers in the 1940s or 50s when the waves were down. Surfers were looking for something to do when someone decided to attach roller skate wheels to the bottom of a board. Sidewalk surfing was suddenly the craze. It became even more popular in the 1960s with music and TV shows. Skateboarding has since grown into a popular action sport that many guys at Frisco High School participate in whenever they can. Skaters have developed a true skill for the sport and can easily spend hours at the skate parks. Like most action sports, getting good at skateboarding takes time, and most people get on board early. But it is a skill that can stay with you if you keep at it.
And it's unlimited to what you can do on a skateboard. It takes a lot of skill and time to learn these tricks. Getting the tricks done, it's just like you can accomplish something.
As of now, skaters have to go to McKinney or Louisville to find a skate park, but a new one is scheduled to open soon at Coit and Panther Creek. It's quite a ways north, but it's supposed to be really nice. Are you on board? For RACC TV, I'm Taylor Garrow.
Good morning, fellow raccoons. Welcome to the Weekend Weather Watch. I'm Eli Burke.
And I'm Con Sizzle.
Speaking of the weather,
today will be sunny with a high of 75 and a low of 50.
Saturday will be sunny with a high of 78 and a low of 56.
And Sunday will be sunny with a high of 82 and a low of 58.
Today, our FHS raccoons take the AP US History and Computer Science exam. Good luck.
This past weekend at State VASC in San Antonio, Alicia Yu and Patrick Thomas medaled. medal. Alicia Yu's artwork was also awarded the Distinguished Gold Seal, the highest award at State VASU.
Make sure you stop by at the Lake Gate and pick up a Pizza with a Purpose flyer and show it to your server at California Pizza Kitchen, and they will donate 20% of your check to our FHS Natural Honor Society Monday through Wednesday next week.
Congratulations to the FHS Academic Octathlon teams who participated in the regional competition this past weekend. Team 1 placed 5th and Team 2 placed 7th.
For RACC TV, I'm Eli Burke.
And I'm Colin Civil.